You drink like a fish. It's a curious statement if you think about it. Fish live underwater, so why should they have to drink at all? Our bodies, fishes, and everyone else need water. It's the essential solvent for all our chemical reactions. Without it, we would die. Nonetheless, it seems silly that an underwater creature should have to drink. Can't they just, I don't know, absorb it or something? Because we can't put ourselves in a fish's shoes, or rather fins, there's no way for us to know how fish perceive thirst, or if they do at all. But it turns out that some fish actually do need to drink, and others do not. Fish do absorb water through their skin and gills in a process called osmoregulation, which is common to us and many other vertebrates. Osmosis is the flow of water across membranes from areas of low concentration of the salt things to areas of high concentration. It serves basically to equalize the concentration in the two areas. Freshwater fish have it easy. Their blood and bodily fluids are much saltier than the water they swim in, so water flows right through their gills. And they just need to be constantly peeing out diluted urine from the kidneys. They also swallow some water when they eat. I mean, it's kind of unavoidable, but they don't need to actively gulp down water because it dilutes their blood and bodily fluids. The opposite is true for saltwater fish. The challenge here is to avoid losing water to the much saltier environment and to keep excess salt out. As well as getting water through osmosis, the salt inside their body is constantly sucking water out of them. So saltwater fish need to purposefully drink water to get enough into their digestive tract. But since the only water around is salty, they have to filter it out to make it safe for them to absorb through their kidneys. But fish's bodies, just like ours, need a certain concentration of salt to function best. They can't just allow the water to diffuse freely through their gills. The saltwater fish would shrivel up, and the freshwater fish would explode. To avoid that, they need to retain the balance of the concentrations. And that's where chloride cells come in. These are special cells in the gills that produce large amounts of an enzyme that controls the flow of dissolved salts across cell membranes. Freshwater fish use chloride cells that selectively pump salt in or out of their blood, while in saltwater fish, they constantly pump salt out. In a nutshell, freshwater fish would drown in saltwater due to excessive salt intake, while saltwater fish would become dehydrated in freshwater due to salt loss. Then we got the salmon. As anadromous fishes, in their adult life, they migrate into freshwater to reproduce. So there's often a staging area where the salmon hang out before completing their migration, where they're exposed to some brackish water so they can gradually retain more salt in their bodies before migrating to their freshwater spawning grounds. But as climate change rapidly warms the world's waters, fish like salmon may experience fast changing conditions regarding temperature stability in water columns around the globe, which delays their ability to adapt to varying salt content in their environment. So there you have it. While they may never truly know if they get thirsty, just like us, they need to maintain a delicate balance in their bodies to survive. And with climate change, these underwater creatures face even more challenges than before. Thank you for your attention, and bye.